I said before that one of the real difficulties of introducing an outcomes-based approach is writing the learning outcomes, choosing the words. And the other thing that is difficult is varying the level of complexity. I said it was easy to write easy learning outcomes, but not so easy to write the more advanced ones. And we need to do both. Now, there are, in fact, if you look on the internet, there are, in fact, a number of taxonomies around which give you the vocabulary and the levels of cognitive difficulty, etc., that you need to think about when you're writing learning outcomes. But we're going to look at two. One, which is probably the most common, which is Bloom's taxonomy. And the second one, because I like it, which is Biggs' solo taxonomy, which I've been using since the 1980s when he wrote it. So you're going to get both of them. But first, I'll talk about Bloom. You can see from the diagram what Bloom's categories are. If we start from the top, the first one, we have in fact the most simple level of procedural activity, remembering knowledge. This is at a level of shallow processing. And the sort of vocabulary, the sort of key words in writing your learning outcomes are verbs like describe, identify, label, match, memorize, etc. I'm not going to tell you them all because it's boring. You can read them later. The second level of complexity is understanding. So it's not just remembering something, it's understanding it. And for this, the vocabulary is given in his taxonomy. And so you have words like distinguish between, explain, extend, give examples of, illustrate, etc. Moving up once more, as you can see, we have apply. And this is knowing when to apply, why to apply, etc. And here we have words like choose, explain, generalize, judge, organize, etc. One step more, and we have analyze, a word we all use. We bandy about it in universities. It's bandied about with great abandon, and half the people who use it haven't thought about what it means. But what it does mean is things like categorize. Ah, nice one. Classify, compare, differentiate, etc. And then we get to the next level, which is evaluate. This is a where you have to bring together knowledge and from many different sources. And here we have words like appraise, judge, criticize. I'm sure that you will all ask your students to criticize something, but are you always aware that you're asking them to evaluate, and have they practiced this learning outcome? I don't say you haven't, I'm just asking. And the final level in Bloom's is create, which is the famous synthesis of university education, which combines the elements into a pattern in the end. And here we have words like hypothesize, formulate, invent, extend, etc. So Bloom's taxonomy is very, very useful in that it provides you with a whole range of vocabulary at the different levels of complexity that you can use as the key verbs when you're writing your own learning outcomes. Again, you know, don't get hung up about it. For example, explain appears at the easy level and at the complex level in Bloom's taxonomy. doesn't. Don't worry. I wouldn't. Now, what I want you to do now, you can either go on listening and I'll tell you about my hero Biggs, solo taxonomy, or you can do the task at the end of this section.